ramps. Now you're gonna see something I do here. Let me shoot the ramp to demonstrate. We're gonna shoot the ramp, and the ball's gonna come down to this flipper. Now if I let the flipper drop and then try to shoot on the fly, look how much of a hop the ball will take. And I got 60 frames, so you're gonna be able to see all this hop. Look at that! I didn't flip this flipper and I could hit it with the right flipper. That's a ridiculous amount of flipper hop. That should not be on this game. Multiball strategy, and then I'm going to start switching over to modes after this. And modes are the left, I keep pointing to the left loop. Because instead of these just being awards like they used to be, they're now modes. So it's a key difference on this game. Left in lane and right up out the right out lane. A common Ghostbuster strain. Oh! Oh, jeez. I got one jackpot. Oh, gosh. And there's no grace period, I'm sure. I'm sure that didn't give me anything because. Yep, it gave me Cape Canaveral. So the things with, this game was developed by Dutch Pinball. And little tiny little nuances in a Stern or a Williams game that were, you know, established by companies like Williams and pretty much everyone had to copy them are sort of left out sometimes in these boutique games. This channel's marked as mature now, Fish Stick, so you can say darn all you want. But yeah, I actually have had to take this area is so dark in the back here that I've had to like super high expose. Wait, why am I blurry now? Okay. The autofocus shouldn't be on. I've had to like change the brightness and contrast because I have to keep it on. I realized I had to keep the camera on auto exposure in order to get the 60 frames per second for some reason. So tricky. I guess I got 1.5 million on story progress, so it's also bonus to go through the shuttle ramps and stuff. Another skill, a super skill. Keeler was messaging me about a pinball tournament. All my locks are... Actually, 8 million is really not a bad score at all in this game. Alright, we'll see what this mode is. This is light extra ball mode. I already know what it is. But you'll see the cool animation on here that they do. You actually get 30 seconds to do every mode. Went for it on the fly twice, like a moron. Yeah, you get 30 seconds for every mode. And once the mode is completed, whether you beat it or not, you're in a 30-second double scoring period. So it looks like I don't have any chance of lighting this extra ball at this point because I've missed too many times. But if you can, it's definitely doable to hit that right loop four times and I only hit once. That one was the shot. But, oh, actually, I guess I didn't get far enough through the mode to light double scoring. Maybe that's what it is. Sup, Albany Pinhead? How's it going? Thanks for tuning in. Yeah, face cam's choppy. I think this is a problem with the exposure. Also, this face cam's max 30 frames per second. It was down to 10, and I think it's a little higher than 10, but it's probably only like 15 now. Unfortunately, there's also like USB issues and power issues and stuff that are all sorts of annoying that wouldn't be here if I was using a camera that had its own power source to it, not a USB camera, or had like a physical rig with a power supply instead of a laptop power supply. So little things like that are just little nuisances. But the 60 frames per second is, I think it's the playfield's the most important. And it definitely looks way better at the 60 frames. Lighting in here leaves something a little bit to be desired, but actually the adjusting the brightness and contrast a little bit has made it viewable, I think. You still have these super bright areas here because of the contrast. And really when I'm looking at this, it looks like such soft light to me. But it looks like such a bright white light there. And that's just because it's an LED light, I guess. But the GI on this game is generally pretty dark. Was that the end of ball three? No, it wasn't. Okay. So, despite all my complaints, this has actually been a pretty good game. I only need one more ram shot to start the multiball. Albany Pinhead, if you remember the Pintastic New England tournament, this is the exact same Bride of Pinbot they were using, but now it has the upgrade on it. So you notice things like the left flipper hop is terrible, just like it was there. I've got to work through it. Alright, I don't like any of these balls on my... Too many balls on my right flipper, I can't really do much with them. And a good double drain. Alright, well, like I said, it's time to talk about modes in this game. 11 million is honestly like close to the leaderboard. And I think I can get a lot more points out of the modes in this game anyhow. So I'd at least like to show a few of them off. Because they're definitely changed. Right now, the pop upper's changed, the one that's lit. It starts with only the small wheel modes can be lit. So right now the extra ball mode is lit. I don't know why I shot the ramp. I should be thinking about it, something else. Hey, Buffalo Pinball, thank you so much for the host. Welcome everybody from the Buffalo Pinball stream. Get the bro emojis up in chat. Thanks everyone who's tuned in. You're taking a look at Bride of Pinbot 2.0 here at the Sanctum in Meriden, Connecticut. This game I just started, we're going to be doing a mode run to show off the various modes in this game. So, if you guys haven't seen this game before, Bride of Pinbot 2.0 is a modification kit you can buy to Bride of Pinbot. But what's unique about it is it redoes the entire game code from the lighting effects, like here, this is all different. Every mode is different. The dot matrix display is entirely unique to this. This has all been modified here as part of the Bride of Pinbot kit. And it makes the game significantly better. This game is known to be like not tournament worthy because of the billion point shot and how that's unrecoverable and it's all luck based. And this actually puts a lot more skill back in the game and it gives you a lot more avenues to go through the game. And that's a lot of cool stuff too, and I'm trying to get the mode started on this tricky right or left orbit shot. It's called the left scoop shot, I guess, by the game. To show a mode. Right now, 50k is lit. That's honestly one of the best modes in the game. So let's pass it over here. Do some nice tip passes and stuff. All the pros in chat. Here we are, 50k mode. So normally this would just give you 50,000 points in Bride of Pinbot. In Bride of Pinbot 2.0, you get 50,000 points per spinner hit. So you're thinking, wait a minute, 50,000 per spinner? That can be a lot of points. And look at that. Look at my score just go up really fast every time I hit that spinner. Let's see if I can back in on the fly. That was a stupid idea. I saved it. Let's do a regular backhand. Nope, that didn't work. There we are. That's a big hit, up to 3 million. And you see the timer also pauses a little bit when it's in the bumpers. So I'm being super aggressive on the spinner because I think it is pretty huge value. And the mode's over, the jackpot increased, and my next mode's lit, it's the 100k mode. But if I hit these pop bumpers, because I didn't beat the mode and you have to hit a certain threshold of stuff to be considered beating the mode, only my small wheel modes are lit still. So I have to beat the mode according to the game to get double scoring and to get to my big wheel modes. So, extra ball mode, which is honestly one of the worst, is lit. I got a lock. Take a lock when I get him. I'm not really thinking about locks. Flippers appear to have too much travel also. I don't know what you mean by travel, Albany. Oh, I think I know what you mean. When I hold up the flipper coming down the in lane, the ball can move too far over. I believe that's what you mean. And yes, that's true. But it compensates for the flipper hop a little bit, where just holding up the flipper is a better move. All right, here we are. We're gonna hit the pop bumpers. So what's up, people? I only see bros in chat. I don't see anyone chatting. Perhaps they're all in the Buffalo chat still. So there's 100k per pop-upper hit. And I demonstrate mode by draining. Such an awful time, just totally brick the shot. But you can get a lot, you get stuck in that pop-upper cluster, you can hit 10 pop-uppers for a million points, which is pretty big. One strategy I've started going for is I try to get the super skill shot on the 50k every time. Because it's more than any of the base skill shots, and it's the most consistent one. So it's the safest way to just get the most points there. You can get up to a million on your super skill shot. Alright, this mode's actually pretty cool. This left loop, which you almost never shoot in the Bride of Pinbot game, becomes very important here. And you've got to... Oh man, these slingshots are killing me. Try to shoot it four times. Woo! Voof, do something worthy of chatting. Oh, wait, now I can use drain. Oh, yeah. Yo, Tim. Sup, Buffalo Pinball. Thank you for hosting me. Man, I kind of botched every mode there. Where'd that kid go?
He looked like he wanted to play.
I have a special guest. It's by John Trudeau, and it's by, even worse, it's by Python. I may have revised my least liked designer to Python Angelo, but he didn't really make a lot of solo games. But Chris Point, who's a player here, who he's been on the stream a few times, but he's not always a big fan of playing on. He's a funny guy. I wish I could get him on here more. Has told me there's not a single good Python game. Spamps, what's going on? Tim, hello. Spamps, hello. All right, let's light this extra ball finally. No! This is such a small play field with stupid sensitive slingshots. And, to use Bruce's favorite turn, you can put polish on a turd, but it's still a turd. Extra ball mode. We haven't done this one yet. I have so much trouble shooting this scoop shot on the fly. Missing early and late. Where's Beer Bro this evening? Beer Bro refuses to play this game because he had to play it, he says, every round of the 24-hour battle, and he lost every single time. Now, the question is, did I, knowing that, pick this game so he wouldn't be here? Or did I just want to play this game? It's a big mystery. But Beer Bro has told me maybe he'll duck his head in, but he really hates this game. But he played it back when it was Bride of Pinbot 1.0 as well. Sounds like he needs practice. Vavoof, have you ever played a Bride of Pinbot 2.0? I'm not talking about the pinball arcade version where you get 20 billion and it's a good score. A real one in the wild has to be somewhat one of the most frustrating games. Now you're gonna see something I do here. Let me shoot the ramp to demonstrate. We're gonna shoot the ramp, and the ball's gonna come down to this flipper. Now if I let the flipper drop and then try to shoot on the fly, look how much of a hop the ball will take. And I got 60 frames, so you're gonna be able to see all this hop. Look at that! I didn't flip this flipper and I could hit it with the right flipper. That's a ridiculous amount of flipper hop. That should not be on this game. But someone should honestly clip that because I didn't even realize I was able to do that. I could hit the, let the ball go down the left in lane and hit it with the right flipper. Should not happen. So every single time you'll see me defensively hold this left flipper up because the shots are simply unpredictable on this flipper with the big bounce. Flipper hop hurts my eyes. If you guys check out Albany Pinhead's YouTube channel, which I think I've actually linked as one of the like related channels on my YouTube channel at Timballs. What is this? Suit Jeps. Oh, here we are. So you can see this can be a lot of points. Of course, it requires me actually hitting the shot and hitting pop bumpers. There's also a lot better sound, well, not better, a lot different sound package, but the speakers are really nice. I actually really do like the sound design of Bride of Pinbot. My brother says got a Bride of Pinbot 2.0 built, so it's too pretty and won't play it. He's gonna get another one, but he promised me months ago and I won't let me play it. Be a frustrated game. There are achievements though, I keep forgetting to do this, but when you start the game here like this, you're on ball one. If I hold in both flippers, I can select a profile, and style selects Tim Sexton, myself, on the recent profiles. This tracks my achievements and stuff. So I got one for starting multiball on the other game. I probably already have the one for the super skill shot. I don't actually know. Oh, I know what this can do. If you do connect this game to the internet, which is possible, you can have stuff like global leaderboards tracked by it. It's cute you think I only play Pinball Arcade, though. I'm saying if you think this game is easy, it might be because you play the Pinball Arcade version. Or it might be because you played a version that's not this. This is honestly one of the most frustrating Bride of Pinbots I've ever played. The tilt's also tighter than I'd like it to be, but these games are still kind of set on 24-hour battle settings. The scoop is such a tight shot, and it's not as important of a shot on the regular Bride of Pinbot. Yeah, that's also true. Like, that makes it a better game. But, like, there we are. You gotta get it all the way up into that scoop. So we're in extra ball mode, and this one's really tough. You actually have to complete your four lanes, which is really only possible by shooting. See, that nonsense. Most are not forgiving. That was not forgiving. I don't know how I'm supposed to handle that beat besides flipping away, which is silly in this game, because you're gonna hit these posts and drain, or trying to live catch, which was botched. These don't look like Supermans. So, live catches might be a little trickier. And the freaking slingshots are gonna kill me. They're so sensitive. Your flipper hop. Thank you, Spams, for the clip. You see, I've got all the Twitch lingo down already. I've been streaming for about 4 months. I already know when to tell people to... Here's the point. I need you to rant about Python Angelo.
He's already dead.
I know.
You can't kill him again.
But how... What did you say about his designs? Are there any good ones? Python Angelo games?
No. It's not. He did Popeye.
Right.
I mean, Rick loves Popeye. Super. He never had any good designs. My favorite design of Python Angelo is Bad Cats, which is a really shitty design. And he said that he was embarrassed at that design because they just had to get it out the doors because there was nothing on the line at that time. I don't like any of his designs. I was infatuated with him
the video game stuff.
From a philosophical standpoint.
Yeah.
He's a really shitty game designer, and he seems like a really shitty guy that would have to work with.
I see themes of sexism in most of his games.
Oh, yeah.
A little bit, yeah.
Oh, yeah, you don't have to hide.
No.
Oh, yeah, he's
Everyone is requesting beer, bro. Guys, you're gonna drive me insane.
Oh, God.
He won't pick this. He won't play this game. He hates this game.
Yeah, he doesn't like it.
Yeah.
We can make that happen.
Are you at all interested in playing on camera?
Sure.
Yeah.
I'll play one. I mean, I'm not, but if it makes you happy, it doesn't make you happy.
Yeah, because this game's frustrating me, and I want to complain about Python.
I mean, I'll get them up like that one day. I just been listening to that fucking podcast episode.
Yeah.
It's nuts. He just says the whole fucking time. He goes, You need to read the Fountainhead. You need to read the Fountainhead.
What ethnicity is he?
He's Romanian.
Okay.
His actual name's fucking Python.
So what was he from? He was from Romania?
He was from Romania and he came to the U.S. Sometime, I think. I don't know. I don't the internet right now, so I'm not gonna.
Yeah.
I'm not gonna make a guess. He was a Disney illustrator, and he's actually really fucking incredible.
His art is good, yeah.
His art's like really awesome.
I hit a spinner. I got one wheel spin, one loop shot. Hi, Siren X, how's it going? Color DMD, nice. Hey, this is Bride of Pinbot 2.0. They all come with color DMD. You can't get a non-color DMD, or single color DMD, I guess, for this game. This is our special guest Point. Point is from the deep in the arcade scene where Python Angel also spent a lot of time.
Python helped on Joust, and Python also christened one of the champions of Joust as one of the greatest arcade gamers of all time, but I'll be the first to tell you he's not. Joust is cool though. Python bounced around, and I love the fucking story that. Sorry, I didn't mean to say the fuck word.
No, you're allowed to. It's a mature stream.
Oh, okay.
They have to click on I want to watch I'm Avery 17 or something.
Python talking about designing Zingy Bingy. This was actually fucking great. Python says, the guy from Topcast interviews him. He says, "Oh, how did Williams respond to Zingy Bingy?" And he goes, "The women loved it. The women loved it." Which, like, the actual story that's been corroborated by a couple of cats is that the head of production saw the game, and once he saw it, he got back on the plane, and then the next day, Williams closed the pinball.
Captain.
Yeah. So the women loved it.
You also said the president or vice president left without saying a word.
Yeah, not a word.
Yeah.
Not a word.
And he just went back on the plane.
Yeah.
And then Capcom pinball was no more.
How did this game fare? He goes, "The women loved it." That's not a real response.
Yeah.
It's a game where women and men can play together. That's
yeah. Every pinball game. Yeah.
You can play fucking checkers. Like.
So, did he envision, like, men were on the right side or something and women were on the left? Because this game literally has a penis flipper. Like, it has an upper flipper where the man's thing would be. Like, and he's, like, printed on the playfield and it has a flipper sticking out and it goes up and down.
The funny thing is, he goes, "It was just like Bride of Pinbot. It was the pop-overs and the ramps were the boobs." he defends it to the highest degree.
So what is his, why does he think the president shut down the company? Or why does he think Capcom closed? Like, what was his conclusion from that whole fiasco where 2 days...
We'll never know.
He doesn't have it, I guess.
No, he thought he was doing a great thing that would maybe, like, benefit people.
Right. And how much money did Flipper Football lose?
Oh, God. A ton. A ton. It had to lose a ton. What a nut. I sent him a letter 2 days before he died.
Yeah.
Just to say, "Hey, I really like your art." I didn't just suspend ball designs, but I don't care for those. But his art's really cool. No, he was an interesting guy.
The games where he's like listed as a partial designer, like Cyclone, are actually pretty cool games. Where he's not the first build. how your ramp works in this game. It's a drain shot. You gotta hit it like so perfect. And I've actually started going for the super skill shot. So the way this works, if you guys see all these lights flashing, is instead of the lane just giving you whatever the value says, if you plunge it at the same time, and if I hit that 100K, it would be worth 5X the value. So that one would be worth 500,000. I hit the 200,000, then it's worth a million. So that's a little cooler that they did that on the skill shot to give more skill to it. It gets harder as it goes on, the more you get. Alright, impossible mode started. Shoot the ramp 4 times mode, pretty much. There's a nice live catch. Now I gotta shoot my heartbeat ramp or something to light these in lanes. I've been out of control for a couple minutes now. A little more time than I thought. I have like 60 seconds to complete that one. I thought they were all 30.
Python highly suggests that you read The Fountainhead by Ayn Rand.
I actually have read it as like a teenager.
Did you like it?
At the time, yeah. I got older and
you moved on?
Yeah. It's a great ideology for someone who is mentally a teenager, because you're not able to understand the world as anything but a bunch of self-interested, totally wrapped up in themselves people. Here's my criticism of Ayn Rand. I know most gamers are very keen on their objectivism critiques and stuff. But, yeah, I think at some point of your life, I don't think, like, too far past, like, 20 or so, you can really get that much into objectivism. There are some people who stick with it, though, and somehow they become Silicon Valley billionaires. I'm not sure exactly how it happens. Like, Peter Thiel. Yeah, I know, we are. Well, but I don't... Do I really want to be Peter Thiel and be, like... one of the most evil men on the planet?
Do you?
Nah, I don't think so. I think I'd rather just play pinball.